Hello and welcome back to Excel Sip. This is the third video in our Excel keyboard shortcuts, tips and tricks series. We have already covered the keyboard shortcuts for Excel beginners in our first video. Then we moved to part 1 of the advanced Excel shortcuts and tricks, where we covered the cell contents and cell formatting bit. In this video, we'll cover the formulae and navigation bit. Don't forget, I have a free PDF with the list of all these advanced shortcuts that you can download from the link in the description, or you can use the QR code shown in this video. Let's begin. When you are an advanced user of Excel, there are some side effects that come with it. There's a famous movie dialogue, "With great power comes great responsibility," something like that. You get to handle huge data files, files with hundreds of rows and columns. I routinely work with Excel files that are minimum 20 MB in size. And to make matters worse, most of the time, they are loaded with various lookups, conditional formatting and whatnot. And that makes working on them a lot harder. There's a simple fix to that. Once your file is loaded, like we have our file here, every time I change something that has a formula depending on it, like this sales figure, which has the ratings and percentage depending on it, Excel will recalculate the whole thing because my change in sales figure could mean change in rating and the percentage. And this takes significant resources when the data is huge. To fix this, what I do is go to the Formula tab and in the Calculation group, click on Calculation Options and choose Manual. Now, whenever I change anything here, nothing happens. What I have done is, I had disabled the automatic calculation in Excel to save my system resources, so I can work uninterrupted and whenever I need it to check, I can press Shift F9 to calculate manually like this. Shift F9 will work only on this sheet. If you are to press F9, that will recalculate all worksheets. So make sure you know which option you're choosing. Because if you pressed F9 in a file that has many sheets and all of them have used datasets and formulas, you're looking at a couple of minutes before you can continue, which kind of defeats the purpose. I have a nested if formula here in the ratings column. You may have also come across formulae which seem to go on forever, and the best way to review them is to expand the formula bar by pressing Ctrl, Shift and U. Once you're done, you can use the same shortcut again to change it back to the original size. We know Excel has hundreds of formulae and it's not possible to remember all of them. We only tend to remember those which we use more often. What if we come across something that we know Excel has the formula for, but don't remember the exact thing? Googling it is one option, or you can use the Insert function dialog by pressing Shift and F3. Let me show you. Let's say I have to find the square root of this number here in F2. I'm pretty sure that there must be a formula in Excel that does that, but since I don't use it frequently, I don't know where to start. So I press Shift F3 and in this box here, I type square root and hit go. It shows me three formulae for square root and if I click on them, it also shows me a brief description of what they do. Pretty good if you ask me. I'm interested in this one, so I highlight it and press OK. It asks me for the argument, which is the number, so I select our cell F2 and press Enter and here it is, the square root of this number. Some of you may think that this shortcut should have belonged in the beginner's video and it's too simple. And you would be right in thinking that, but this shortcut has an ace up its sleeve. I showed how to look for a formula, but this nifty little thing can actually help you evaluate a formula as well. Let's select a cell with a formula. We have our ratings calculated by nested if. Let's select F2 and now press Shift and F3. And here we have step-by-step breakup of our formula. It shows the logical test and the results for it, false, and then shows us the value if true, which would have been 5, and since it's false, it shows us the result here as 3. This can come in pretty handy for most of us. Some of you might have used named ranges. I have used it in my advanced filter video where at 1210 timestamp, I have used name ranges to demonstrate automatic filtering of data. They're basically names provided by the user to a certain range which can further be used in functions. Let me give you a quick example. Let's select the sales cells from F2 to F10. Press our shortcut Alt-MMD to bring up the new name dialog box and type our name here without any spaces. So let's write sum sales. Hit OK. And now, if we have to say sum this particular set of cells, we can simply start with sum and for number argument, just type the name we gave, sum sales. And Excel automatically shows it like this. Select it and done. If you ever forget what name you gave it, when you are in the argument section of the formula, press F3 and it'll bring up all the defined names in the worksheet. If you work with VBA, you can access the VBA editor by pressing Alt F11. And if you are interested in macros, you can manage the macros by pressing Alt F8. And for Power Query lovers, you have Alt and F12 to bring up the Power Query editor. It might take some time to load though, depending on your system speed, of course. Okay, now we are in the last category, navigation. Again, just like the basic Excel keyboard shortcuts, these will be used the most. First up is Control G. This one gets you to a cell in a jiffy. If you know where to go, of course. Say we know we have our totals in F102 and we need to check that. Instead of scrolling and scrolling, press Control G and type F102 here. And you are there. To access different tabs, you don't need your mouse to go up. Just use Alt-H for Home tab, Alt-N for Insert tab, Alt-P for Page Layout, Alt-A for Data tab, Alt-W for View, Alt-R for Review tab, and Alt-M for the Formula tab. And when you get to the tab you want, you still can work through the keyboard. You see these letters mentioned on the functions? Press Alt and any of these letters and it brings up that function. Like I need to check the defined names, so I press Alt N and here comes the name manager. Alt key actually, if pressed alone, can bring up all sorts of shortcuts on itself. Like if I just press Alt here, it shows you all these letters you can press to go to the corresponding menu and subsequently function you want to. So you really don't need to remember the combination, just press Alt and follow the prompts. How do you know how many cells have data in your sheet or how many formulae? You use the workbook statistics dialog box, of course. Press Ctrl, Shift and G to bring it up and it shows you all this info about the current sheet and the whole file as well. If you are ever in a contest about who is working on a more complex file, you can use this to prove it to your colleagues. If you need to zoom in or out, you can use Ctrl and Alt with the plus and minus keys from the number pad. You know you can select the cells using Ctrl and Shift with arrow keys like this. But if you press F8, you see this extend mode come up down here, right next to accessibility. Now you can simply use the arrow keys to move around and all the cells will be selected. And if you press Shift with F8, you can add or remove non-adjacent cells as well from this selection. Let me show you a quick use case scenario. Let's say we have to sum up our sales from F90 to F95 and then jump to F99. We start with sum here and then get to our F90, press F8 and use our arrow keys to get to F95. And you can see all these cells are now in a sum formula. Now we need to get to F99, press Shift and F8 and you will see this add or remove selection mode up here. And in our sum formula, our non-adjacent cell F99 has cropped up. Just press Enter and your formula is done. And that brings us to the end of this video and our series about Excel keyboard shortcuts, both for beginners and advanced users. I hope you've learned something new from this video and that you've learned some more tricks up your sleeve. Before I finish this video, here is the link for the PDF with all these advanced keyboard shortcuts that I promised. You can download it for free. I'll also paste a link to this file in the description of this video. I'll see you in the next one. Until then, subscribe if you haven't already, share and comment. Happy spreadsheeting.